Hey everyone, thank you for joining me here today to do a video about Philips AVENT 4-in-1 electric steam sterilizer. I'm going to talk about a couple things and give my thoughts on this, go over the pricing, how to use this, some tips on cleaning it, and just some also a parental warning in case you're thinking about buying this. So this costs $90, which is pretty pricey. We got this as a gift for a baby shower. So, oh Lord. it's $90. You can get this at jet.com for $72.90 or amazon.com also for $72.90. You can save yourself some money if you really do want to buy this. This thing sterilizes. It heats up the product. It's like a steam function. It gets really hot inside, and according to online, according to the manufacturer, it sterilizes, it sterilizes 99.9% for up to 24 hours as long as you keep it inside. So, you know, you can sterilize something, you can leave it in there for the next day if you want, and it'll still be clean. This thing runs on a 6-minute cycle, so I guess from when you turn it on, it does this thing, and it's done in 6 minutes. And, let me show you the compartments. This little cap that comes on there. This is the top compartment here where you can put the pacifiers, little caps, breast pump, any kind of like baby accessories that you want to clean. You can put it there in the top compartment. And this is like the little dishwashing accessory. I guess it's supposed to be for convenience. Put the bottles in there. You just transfer it and put it in there. All right, and then there's a bottom part to this. This is where you have to put water here to get this thing started. I hear a lot of people, I saw a lot of reviews on Amazon and a lot of people complaining, oh, this thing rusts and, you know, it rusts really fast. This actually comes off really easy. Let me just get a paper towel. From what I read online, supposedly this just, you can wipe this. See how most of it kind of comes off already just by wiping. But like you see some of the brown spotting there, you get an angle. Well, let me get an angle and zoom it in a little bit. There's a little bit of brown, slight brown, right? So what you can do from what I read online is you can put some vinegar in there and let it sit overnight. Come the next day and it's going to be clean. So that whole thing with the rust and all that stuff, it comes out easy. It's not a worry if you're considering buying this. Let's see what's next. So let me show you how to use it. You just fill this part with water. So you just come here like that. Just enough to fill the metal part. Okay, and you put your top compartment on there. Let me give you the warning now, the parental warning for this that I didn't know about. Online, Philips says that you can fit up to 11-ounce bottles, but it has to be the Philips brand that can fit in there for 11-ounce. So, for example, because we have different baby bottles, we try different products, all right? For example, our Dr. Brown's bottle, this bottle here is a little over 8 ounces, right? So, online it says you can fill up to 11, but if you put this in here, right, and this is only 8, a little over 8, and then you put this part here, it won't allow it to fully close. And there's a gap. It's kind of like a little, let me see if I can show you guys. Zoom in. See like this little gap? It won't fully close. So be very careful if you plan on buying this and you're going to be using different size baby bottles and you have the Dr. Brown's, it might not fit on there and it might not close, and then you're not going to get a sterile product. So that's a word of caution. If you're actually planning on buying this and you have different bottles, you might want to make sure, because then you're kind of wasting your money. So we still use this. We use this for all the other little accessories, and then we have several other different types of baby bottles that fit in there with no problem, but the Dr. Brown's unfortunately does not fit in there. So it's a warning. All right, so I have my water in there. All you have to do is flick the switch. Let me zoom in for you. See there, it's just really simple, a little switch at the bottom. You flick it, a little orange light comes on. This thing gets really hot, so word of caution. you know, careful if you have your hands around this. Don't open this before it's done. And then when it's done, you might want to wait a little bit to make sure that it's cooled off so that you don't burn yourself. All right. Let me see if there's anything else. Oh, it comes, the manufacturer comes with a 2-year warranty. So if you have any problems, I already told you about removing the rust with the vinegar and the 6-minute cycle and the pricing. Let me just give my thoughts about this. This is a nice product, right? Like, it sterilizes your bottles, your accessories, cleans it down really nice. You're not supposed to put, like, I don't think you can take dirty bottles full of milk or like half with milk and stuff and throw it in there. This is meant for once you wash it, and then you want to actually kill the bacteria. You know, you want to be super safe. Maybe you're a germaphobe. Maybe there's a lot of parents. I know people personally that I know that are germaphobes. You know, this is probably a product for you. But if you're not a germaphobe and you're just, that's not your thing, for the $90, if you're on a budget, I would say that this is not a necessity. This is not like a, a must have, you know. We use it sometimes and it's nice to have around the house. And, you know, for the $90 though, and if things are tight, I would say don't spend your money on this. But this is a great product to put on your baby registry, or if you do have the money and you just want to be clean and safe, this is great too. We don't even use this product that often. Like, you know, we just use this once in a while just to get everything clean, and then we don't use it again for, I mean, I don't know, like 2 weeks or something, a week or 2 weeks. So that's just my thoughts on that. So I'm going to pause it here for you, and I'll unpause it when it's done, show you what it looks like on the inside. All right. Hey everyone, I'm back. The cycle's over. It didn't even take 6 minutes. It was, I don't know. It was like 2 minutes, but I think that this is probably actually still in cycle. Like, even when the light turns green and it's done, you should probably wait a few minutes, but I'm going to open it up now to show you. See how hot it is? Maybe you can hear the steam burning down. Be careful. Like, this is really hot right now. The product's nice and clean. So, I mean, this just really cleans your products. It sterilizes it, kills the bacteria. This is also good if, like, let's say you are on a budget and you have people that are giving you, like, bottles, like hand-me-downs. I mean, you know, or breast pump stuff, and you know, maybe they have cleaned it, maybe you really wiped it down, but you want to do a final cleaning on it and you really want to sterilize it and kill all the bacteria, this is a good thing to do also. One of the things I saw online too, just to bring up, there was somebody that posted a picture of I think it was this part, or let me see what part it was and be careful. Okay, no, it was this bottom part. Somebody on amazon.com. You see all the water's gone in there. It's already, zoom in, it's already evaporated. And it gets kind of like those little white spots on the metal. It's not a big deal. But somebody on Amazon.com posted a picture of this part. And like all this was melted off when they said, oh, after 2 uses of using this, that the metal thing burned. Like, I mean, not the metal thing, the plastic thing burned. And, you know, it's, this is no good, all that stuff. So, you know, it probably did happen to this person and that sucks, but we've used this more than a dozen times and there's never been a problem. It's pretty safe from my personal experience. It shuts off, you know, and I've never had anything burning, overheating, any smelling, burning smell or anything like that. So from my personal experience, this is pretty safe. I would, like I said earlier, I would deem this non-necessity. And as a dad, like, this is cool to have. It's just, it's not one of those things that really makes things easier. This is just more of like a preventative, being clean, going the extra mile and cleaning your baby stuff. So leave me a comment. Let me know if you have a sterilizer, you know, a thing like this at home, or if you know of a cheaper one or something else, a different method, it doesn't cost as much to sterilize your baby products, right? Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. Take care.